My name is Ben Schoner. I'm one of the co-founders of ThingMagic and I'm currently VP of Business Development of the Trimble division, ThingMagic. We actually started ThingMagic without RFID in mind. We actually stumbled across it. What we were planning on doing in the fall of 2000 when we started ThingMagic was to work on technologies that are small, that are networked, that have a small amount of computing on board, and that it would be ubiquitous out there in the world. That's the kind of field that we were collectively in when we worked at the Media Lab. We all had different backgrounds. ThingMagic was founded by 5 founders, all with a different focus, but we were all PhD candidates at the Media Lab, and that was sort of the technology that we were working on. When we started ThingMagic, the plan was to work with customers, work with corporations to basically bring those technologies into the real world. ThingMagic was lucky to sort of ride that second wave of RFID deployments in the retail supply chain to find an acquirer of the company. We got sold to Trimble Navigation in the fall of 2010. And have been very happy with that transition of the startup into now a division of a major international corporation. There's a lot of respect for the technology and the engineering skill that we have at ThingMagic. We started working with the Auto ID Center. They were really a customer of ours. We developed the first EPC RFID reader, where EPC stands for electronic product code, for them, and along with a bunch of other sort of early vendors at the Auto ID Center, including Alien Technologies, including NXP or Philips as it was called back then. We were basically putting the first set of technology together that would then fuel this retail supply chain boom that we saw in the mid-2000s in RFID. RFID readers are actually very complex devices. And the interesting insight is the smaller you make them, the more complex it gets, and the harder it gets to stay on top of things and consider all the various factors that come in when you design that little object and device. So for example, compliance with electromagnetic emission standards becomes harder and harder as the smaller you make that thing, right? And the more regions you want to push it into, the harder it gets, especially when you try to do it in the same package, with the same set of components. It took us 10 years to learn how much time we have to spend on testing and on evaluating and constantly checking that everything is correct with our products. It's not a you do it once and then you're done type of process. You have to constantly be on the alert, make sure, certainly for new product introductions, that everything is in check with regulations and with the performance standards that we have set for ourselves long before. And then once we're in production, it's the same thing. Constantly check on your own work, constantly check on what the contract manufacturers are doing to make sure you're staying compliant and you're staying on top of things. I personally had to go through that process of learning, and today the majority of our development time is really effectively spent on testing.
Hi, I'm Debbie Power. I'm with ThingMagic and I am a sales manager here. A little bit about ThingMagic. We've been working with UHF for over 15 years, so we have very deep expertise in this area. Recently we were purchased by Trimble, so we are part of a very large $2.5 billion multinational company. Large companies that want to do business with large companies can feel comfortable with ThingMagic. Some of the other things that ThingMagic brings to the table for our customers are very strong manufacturing strengths, high volume requirements, high quality. ThingMagic has been in business since 2000, so we've been serving the UHF market for over 15 years. We offer a broad portfolio of products and services to our customers, who are primarily systems integrators and OEMs. In order to serve our range of customers, ThingMagic has 3 different areas of offerings. One is finished readers, embedded modules, and the last one is application development platforms and tools. For finished readers, The Mercury 6 is a rugged 4-port reader that offers very superior high performance. It has our M6E module inside of it. It can go up to 31.5 dBm with regular PoE. It supports onboard applications, so if you want to do some calculation and not burden your network, you can do that. And we have an integrated Wi-Fi option. The Astra EX uses much the same electronics as the Mercury 6. It just offers a different form factor. So instead of the 4 ports that the Mercury 6 has, the Astra EX has one 10-inch integrated antenna and one extra port that can go up to 31.5 dBm. The Astra EX is used where an integrated antenna can really bring advantages in terms of simpler and more elegant installations. We also have the Vega reader, which we built for a major automotive company, and that was designed for using in vehicles. It's very rugged, has 3 antenna ports, and can connect directly to the car battery without draining it. And finally, we have the USB Plus reader, which is an all-in-one reader that connects to your PC via the USB port, has an integrated antenna, and that's used for tag commissioning, check in, check out. It's installed in many kiosks and used in event management. In order to best serve our customers, we offer a range of modules with a range of performance, form factors, and price points. At the high end, we have the M6E module, a 1.4 watt or 31.5 dBm high performance module that can read up to 750 tags per second. In the middle, we have the Micro and the Micro LTE, which can read 750 and 50 tags per second, 1-watt modules. And at the low end, we have the ThingMagic Nano, a 27 dBm, 1-port module, which is ideal for small form factor, low price point, and low power consumption. For the initial development with modules, we offer development kits, which include a module sitting in a PCB chassis that allows you to easily connect to a PC and use our Mercury API, which runs across all of our products, to develop their software. One of our newest application development tools is called the Express Sensor Hub. The Express Sensor Hub is a platform for designing application-specific products embedding our UHF modules. So you start with a module on a printed circuit board, and we have a number of options so that there is a lot of flexibility around building the reader. Some of the options are PoE, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and GPS. So there are virtually 15 different combinations that you can make with our Express Sensor Hub. One important software tool that we have is the Universal Reader Assistant, or URA. And that is software that's readily downloadable from our website, runs on any PC, and can help you understand how the performance of various tags and antennas is being accomplished. You can use it to commission tags, you can use it to lock tags, read user memory. It's all very graphically driven and very easy to use. So a customer who wants to develop an application-specific product would start with our development kit, use that to develop their software using our Mercury API, which does run across all the products. Once they have the software written, they then would move to the Express Sensor Hub. They put their compiled C code on that, make sure that the application works the way they want it to, and then we provide all the engineering files, the Gerber files, printed circuit design. The components that we use are pre-screened for worldwide certifications, so you don't have to worry about that. Then you just send those files off to the manufacturer of your printed circuit board, and they will make it in whatever form factor you require. All ThingMagic products go through a rigorous testing process that results in high quality and performance. This testing ensures high customer satisfaction in virtually any RFID deployment.
I'm Mike Klein. I'm the Director of Support and Systems Engineering at ThingMagic, and I'm going to take you through some of our test systems. So this is an example of a use case specific environment we've set up to better assist customers create solutions. In this case, in-vehicle asset tracking. One of the typical challenges that customers face when trying to create in-vehicle asset tracking solutions is they often have to work within an existing environment, and the end user doesn't necessarily want to change the shelves and the cabinets that they're currently using. And those items are often made of metal and can present fairly significant RF challenges. One of the things having this type of use case specific setup allows us to do is to fully characterize the RF behavior in order to optimize antenna placement and to determine the best tags to use and the best tag location for the assets being tracked. Another benefit that we can get out of this type of setup is to be able to experiment with configuration changes. For example, removing existing cabinets and shelving, and then demonstrating the benefits that can be gained if the customer moves to RF neutral materials, such as plastic shelving. So using an environment such as this allows us to work with our partners who are developing in-vehicle asset tracking solutions and help them to optimize their solution using ThingMagic readers for a specific use case. So this is a look at an item from our ThingMagic Museum. This is our range tester, originally developed to test the read range consistency across firmware releases and products. It was built by our engineers back in the early days when we had no money. As you can see, it's built from a garage door opener, climbing rope, a wooden track, and can be computer controlled to automate testing. When it was first built, it was geared towards testing the maximum range and seeing when tags would drop off, so we needed about 7 to 10 feet. It was expanded over time as tags and reader technology improved and now reads out to about 30 feet. Since then, we've moved on to more industrial strength equipment, allowing us to use a read range for additional use cases, including very large and very heavy pallets that we can then move up and down the range, testing the performance of our readers for specific use cases. This is our anechoic chamber. It plays a major role in product development. All the RF testing and tuning occurs in here. It also plays a significant role in helping partners solve complex RF problems. Inside the chamber, you can see a circular device, which is a gimbal that allows you to rotate an object in 360 degrees on the X and Y axis. It's all made of wood, so we eliminate much of the RF interference that a metal device would cause. This is another one of those ThingMagic Museum items that was developed and created by hand in the early days, but is still in constant use today. This setup allows us to test assets and the tags and tag placement on them in order to optimize the position of tags for a specific object, enabling better accuracy and better performance in the field. This test setup was built as a result of an interesting problem we faced trying to test a specific customer use case. We had a customer who was using our M6 reader for high-speed tolling applications. The problem is, in order to test and tune the solution, we needed to simulate tags passing the antenna at very high speeds, which is very difficult to do in a lab, and we don't have racetracks. So our engineers came up with a clever solution to that problem by putting RFID tags inside plastic golf balls and shooting them out of an air gun at high speeds. As you can see, we're able to get to speeds over 100 miles an hour, or about 150 feet per second. As a result of this test setup, we were able to tune the application, and in those scenarios, we were able to read between 5 to 10 times single tag on a reliable basis. And this is another example of how creating unique testing solutions enable us to better assist our partners and customers in solving complex RFID problems. So this is an example of a traditional portal setup. As you can see, it has fixtures containing an M6 on either side of the doorway, each with two antennas and a light stack. Additionally, there's an overhead reader which has an M6 connected to two antennas. And this setup allows us to test a variety of more traditional use cases, including assets or pallets of assets going through doors, personnel management, and a number of others.
One of the reasons why ThingMagic is special as a reader supplier and why we are different from many of our competitors is that we cover the entire range of reader products and form factors. Right? We have very, very small modules in our portfolio. At the other end of the spectrum, we have very complex enterprise level readers. Right? The reason why we can do that is because we focus very much on developing the core technology in the form factor of the modules. So we are known for providing the best and most powerful RFID modules in the industry. In fact, you could argue we really invented that business. And then what we do is we use those very very same modules in our own enterprise level products. You know, we don't reinvent the wheel. We very methodically make sure that that capability, that powerful reader engine, then shows up in an enterprise reader and basically is useful to the enterprise customer that doesn't want to start deploying hardware engineers and design their own infrastructure.